University, Emeritus Professor S. Chinyo, Professor Nkpolu-Oroworukwo. We also have Emeritus Professor
Many also acknowledge as a member of the Prof. Vice Chancellor, former Vice Chancellors and Deputy Vice Chancellors, the Deputy Vice Chancellor and Administration, the Deputy Vice Chancellor and me, His Royal Majesty, Deans and Directors, distinguished ladies and gentlemen, I have the honor to invite the Vice Chancellor to give his opening remarks. The Vice Chancellor.
Former Vice Chancellor of this university, Emeritus Professor Senior Chitu Achiemu, the Deputy Vice Chancellor again, Professor Victor Kujuru, Deputy Vice Chancellor Adelende, Professor Valentine Opepo, the Acting Director of the University, Mrs. Edwards Allen, the Acting University Director, Mrs. Lele Olubeke, the Chairman of the Senior Lectures Committee, Professor Henry Kwebe, and I'm seeing the University Orator. This one is a live orator, a live orator of the university. From the Central Asset Center Committee, and the representative of the Dean, Communication and Media Studies, and Director of Research and Development of the University, Professor Jean Nkpolu. The former Deputy Vice Chancellor of this great university, I'm seeing Professor Goroba, is here with us. I'm also seeing Professor Oruwa, who is also here with us. I see Professor Alex Monson, the Emeritus Professor Alex Monson, was with us. I can also see Emeritus Professor William Aneko, is also here with us. Israel Majesty, this is Felix Otwana, this is the Igbo Ubata Tok of Ubata Kingdom, the one of and it is the doctor, this is Dr. Felix Otwana, this is Igbo Ubata Tok, the one of and when you have Royal Majesty here, it's a way of blessing the university. In a special way, let me recognize my former student, who is now my coach, the Honorable Justice, the Honorable Hugh, John of the University of California. Let me also specially recognize the heads of the campuses here, and I've seen Professor Hammett here. I can see Professor Christopher Ayako, who is the HOCs, and then of course the member of council and the provost, College of Medical Sciences, and chairman committee of provost and deans, who is also here. I think there is an evolution. Members of the 14th Governor Council of the University, I've seen a beautiful, this is a beautiful museum with us. And I'm also seeing a man that is wearing two cars, the director of health services, is a member also of the governing council of our university. It's a good service and gentlemen. Let me in a special way also recognize the dean of the PG School, Professor TDS Abba, and the other deans of the faculties, particularly the one representing the dean of Faculty of Communication and Media Studies. The man that is dean is the man that is performing today, the dean of the Faculty of Communication and Media Studies, Professor Peter Nlemanya. Let me also acknowledge the presence of former members of the National Assembly here present. Oh, I'm seeing the chairman of the Civil Service Commission. concerning that. And then, of course, in a very special way, those that have made it possible for us to be here, the chairman and members of the Protected Council of Chiefs, they are here. Thank you for honoring us. And then, of course, the entire Nkpolu-Oroworukwo community, I want to specially welcome you to your land. Because the man that is able to be able to deal with, that brought all of us here, is the son of the soil. Now, I don't call him anywhere, otherwise, they will be fine if I call him anywhere here. But I know that his people are here. From the community they are here, and then of course the entire Nkpolu-Oroworukwo community. It's your day, because your son has made you proud to get to this level. I welcome you, I appreciate you all. The honor of the women of Nkpolu-Oroworukwo, I welcome you. The Suwa, University of Glasgow Association, we especially also recognize your presence, and welcome you. This is the first thing I said to you. Let me, because man has been there, many young has been this and that. Let me in a special way recognize Professor Nlemanya, former chairman of the Bank of Korea, President General of the Bank of Korea Convention, former dean of the Faculty of Engineering, former rector. So the man has several attacks to his credit. So this is good, ladies and gentlemen. I'd like to very specially welcome you this inaugural lecture today. It's my privilege and pleasure to do so because it's a very special one. This inaugural lecture is remarkable. Because it is coming from the Faculty of Communication and Media Studies, one of the youngest but most vibrant faculties in our university. As we have noticed, this is not just the 103rd inaugural lecture of the university, but it is the first from the Department of Public Relations. The fact that Professor Richard Nlemanya Amadi is one of this lecture is even more remarkable, as he has been in the forefront of the struggle for the establishment of the Faculty of Communication and Media Studies. It impressed members of the community to know that the faculty was operating as the Department of Mass Communication in the then Faculty of Management Sciences, and from there it was honored and made the faculty with four departments. And of course, the Department of Advertising and Public Relations is one of those four departments. The title of the lecture is Entropic and Negentropic Coactions in Humanistic Settings, the Public Relations Metier and Its Dynamics. And of course, as I've said earlier on, it will be delivered by Professor Richard Nlemanya Amadi, the Professor of Public Relations and Media Strategy. The title is not only the past, but in the matter. Let me assure you, that we need not be intimidated by these high-sounding words, which is the hallmark of communication and media studies generally. It is one of the strategies of this profession of the pen. On a lighter note, some of you will notice, and we know, that some of the professors there, when they come and they are going to do grammar, will need to keep an additional parasite to actually know what they are talking about. Not just Professor Richard Amadi, but the others. So that is their honor. That's what we know them for. Big grammar. Although, as a lawyer, prepare this presentation before I carry out a deep open assignment. Nevertheless, the topic of the lecture is of great significance, especially in our public relations, which evolved from the basic need of creating awareness and improving human relations, is acquiring renewed relevance in contemporary society. Since man cannot live without association, there is need for him to properly communicate with others in order to have beneficial relationships. Considering the pedigree of the inaugural lecturer, I have no doubt at all that he is well equipped to demonstrate to us the best way that this can be achieved for the overall benefit of society. So, distinguished ladies and gentlemen, I want to urge you to just sit back and listen attentively to this distinguished professor as he delivers the 103rd inaugural lecture of the University of Nkpolu-Oroworukwo. You will join me to assess whether or not we have delivered on this difficult assignment, and whether the University of Nkpolu-Oroworukwo made a mistake or were right in appointing him as a professor at this university. It's a great pleasure, ladies and gentlemen. I want to thank you for your attention, and God bless all of us.
So, as a school, of the PRAD about. Due to some setbacks in 1982 and subsequently, Professor Amadi, undeterred due to being numerous manual jobs, to respond to rector of general certificate of general certificate admission with a view to securing the required subjects for admission to the university. He was a pioneer beneficiary to me of University Skills Accreditation Authority in 1984 and trained at the University of Super Corporation, the printers and publishers of Nigerian Tire Newspaper. Upon the completion of the training and found what by the corporation for his outstanding performance and ingenuity, he was commissioned as a minister to cover the Jewish human rights. He became quite popular amongst staff and received several awards because of his courageous and important events in the university. In 1986, Professor Amadi was honored with a gold award under the auspices of the National Youth Awards by the former president of Nigeria, Abraham Bakar. The award was initiated by the Federal Ministry of Youth and Social Welfare to honor Nigerian youth from this state of the Federation. Professor Amadi returned to school in 1992 and was one of the pioneer mass communication graduates of the University of Science and Technology then in 1996. Between 1997 and 1998, Professor Amadi served the country through the National Youth Service Team at the Community Secondary School, Ekwebadi. He is a non-local member of Humanistic. After the completion of the AYC, he secured admission into the Prestigious University of Nigeria in Soka, where he obtained a Master of Arts degree in Mass Communication in 2000. In 2012, he was admitted into the Doctor of Philosophy degree in Mass Communication at the Humanistic University of Science and Technology as a Galenatic graduate of the department. Was employed from the Department of Mass Communication in 2000 as an assistant lecturer. Dr. Amadi, over the years, has meritoriously climbed the academic ladder. Lecturer 2 2004, Lecturer 1 2009, Senior Lecturer 2015, Reader 2018, and Professor 2021. Over 100 publications in both national and international journals, Professor Amadi has attended several conferences where he presented high-ranking papers that have aided policymakers in government. Professor Amadi has over the years gained a lot of experience in different capacities: external assessor, external examiner, external facilitator, adjunct lecturer, supervisor, or PhD student in several universities. in designing a two-year communication plan on prevention in flood and management for river recovery. He also participated in developing an archetype model for the communication indicators in 2007 and was involved in stakeholder participation to review campus training in the context of advocacy for community management policy in just 2010. He is a federal member of several professional bodies, including the following: African Council of Communication Education, Advertising Professional Council of Nigeria, Association of Communication Scholars and Professionals of Nigeria, Nigerian Institute of Public Relations, Institute of Mass Communication and Information Management, and the Nigerian Union of Journalists. Prof. Amadi has served the Rusty University community in several positions. He has been student advisor, part-time program coordinator, examination officer, a something of faculty, and for the pioneer team of the Faculty of Communication and Media Studies. It is a chance to know this is that Professor Richard Amadi is also a member of the 13th and 14th Governing Council of the University. Professor Amadi has actively participated in the development of the Nkpolu-Oroworukwo community, which also is our host community, the University of. He is a member of the representative think tank committee. He was the public relations officer of the Nkpolu-Oroworukwo Press Association. He was secretary to the Nkpolu-Oroworukwo Community Development Committee and Constitutional Development Committee of the community. He was a member of the Nkpolu-Oroworukwo Land Allocation Committee. He was chairman of the Nkpolu-Oroworukwo Development Committee and the Nkpolu-Oroworukwo Community Land Allocation Committee in the entire federal court. This is that it will be that is a participant in the settlement of disputes in his community, including land and marital disputes. Professor Amadi is a digitalized Nigerian who is happily married to Mrs. Adeleke Abike Adamadi, an amazing woman from the Yoruba nation, all of them. With me today, Matuson, Pedele, and Kuhar, I think they are fire chief minister. This is ladies and gentlemen, I have the pleasure to present to you the 103rd Inaugural lecture, a leader of the never inside, fourth pioneer, a world above me, a community presenter, a teacher of life, and a renowned scholar, professor, teacher, and a man. Today's inaugural lecture is titled
neurologically, the number one outlet for instance, new beginning, independence, leadership, creativity, and self-expression. Secondly, today's inaugural lecture is the first of its kind to be delivered from the Faculty of Communication and Media Studies. And the Department of Publications and Advertising. The inaugural lecture is said to be the test the professor must pay in the event of being made a professor. In deciding on what topic to speak about, the professor may choose for the following. One, choose the general topic from which to provide fresh and stimulating insight of relevance to the audience. Two, talk about the development of the discipline or department, especially where the occupiers can endure chair within that discipline or department. And three, focus discussion on the success work and how the product of work has concluded the knowledge. Fashion, today's topic is timely, necessary, because our life, our world has evolved in the state of trouble. Therefore, population is the appropriate remedy for us to grow in Nigeria. And other organizations have one way or the other experienced problems, difficulties, and so on as a result of what? Internal problems. Namely, inordinate ambition. These and others propose that if it is not finally tackled, it must bring down the activities of an organization, even families, churches, industries, because human beings are necessarily human beings, and as such, will from time to time introduce negative activities that can bring down the organization or even family. We have experienced a lot in court. Families go to court because of one rule. As an employee man, I know that ordinary one rule has created a lot of money for lawyers. And that also makes the pockets of lawyers. You know, as a lawyer, you must pray for problem. So that okay, in web of humanistic service. Vice chancellor, from the time human people are born, we must ensure that they communicate, they interact. Even when a child communication, that child needs to be breastfeeded. Yeah, human being live and thrive in groups. When we are small, they are what we call egeling. We wrestle, we participated in all activities. As a human being, you must join one group or the other because you must live in a group. And that group necessary can also fashion and also dictate how you behave in the communication that is affected. And if that person do not go well in very high esteem, you will know you know a very bad way. Therefore, that man must exhibit for empathy and emotion, nation of norms, because in every association you join, there are tradition. And that tradition can dictate how you behave or direct you to a very bad state, and there must be division of labor. Each organization fashion activities for any person to perform. Sociology of man. Man is socially dependent being that he was not created to be alone. Even the Bible said that man shall not do what? Be alone. Therefore, he needs a partner. That is marriage. You see, But today, even from the beginning, we are dependent on other people. Students depend on lecturers to learn. Nigeria depends on other countries to succeed. Therefore, there must be that interaction, communication that will create bond among them. Okay? Man, entire society is a match in socialization, socializing. Without government, we socialize, people go to club. People join up as a social school. There is an SU, that's region, and so on. Those associations is what controls the man. In an in-depth look at the sociology of man, convey the fact that man's life consists of it, interactions and interrelations. Interactions and interrelations. We come out from different families. That families have extended families. Families also have extended enemies. Firstly, even in our community, if my enemy overwhelm me, or if I want my enemy, I may also name my child. I have an elder one, God Alaba. That's a God, I'm sure you know. You name it Alaba. If you come to my family today, you say Alaba. You'll be thinking that it's from a job. But no, it's from an employment. It's access. Thank you. It's social. It's social life. One way to go. A man's mental and physical development are shared by society. Society is whole to man, and man is whole to society. The binding of a man and society is communication and interaction. We must promote that. Interdependence and abundance. Man's relationship with society is not serious. There must be anger, misunderstanding, conflict, suspicion. They must misunderstand themselves. I know that when we are younger, we used to say, let's go and sing, yes. Then it was all singing. But the problem is, singing is not talking to us, yes. Alright? And because say, if the handshake passes for the echo, it becomes what? So, yes, it's understanding. The problem is, as a result of our interest, and so on. Catalyst for that correct. A conversation of studies in the subject area is really following as catalyst of that correct in the work of man and society. One, misalignment of explicit and implicit meaning between the sender and the receiver. As a previous channel happened, proclivity for negative interpretation and construction on clear expectation. That person does that. What the grammar that was spoken will be better explained by this figure. We have the source. The source is either myself or any other person. Then we have the message and we have the channel and the receiver. There is a big difference between the source and the receiver. The receiver at the point, if that receiver has malaria, definitely there's an element of not understanding the message. Or if there, because by this noise is have physical noise, we also have physiological noise and other types of noise. Especially the women, when they are writing an exam, you see them sweat. That sweat is noise because it does not alert them to the world through. In 1973-74-76, up to about 90, we were involved with black and white television. Especially the television we have in Portugal. And by 7 p.m., we begin to observe that the television has noise, cracks, that is noise. So if the source sending message and the receiver at the point does not understand the message, then there is what? Noise. So that is what is aligned and can synchronize between and the receiver. Efficacy of humanistic progression. the concept of Humanistic questions is a reciprocal, dynamic, and mutually influential process that occurs between individuals. Where is person influence the experience of other persons? Therefore, humans are fundamentally interconnected. Sometimes you see yourself flying the plane. So, by that aspect, you have connected with unseen. And perhaps my father would say, you have a living.
Bring plastic shares.
That is why you are dreaming. Why you do not have money to even purchase a fire. Secondly, it enhances mutual growth and development in the community. Then, foster atmosphere of mutual respect, empathy, and discovery. Shape societal norms and structure. Contribute to the development of more compassionate, empowering, and transformative society. So, human being, we interact. By way of interacting, we misunderstand ourselves. By that misunderstanding, we now create mutual suspicion. I use the word mutual suspicion because you will be suspecting me, and that will be suspecting you. You will become mutual. Therefore, development will not spread, and you create a world where we are coming to what in trouble. In an organization, for instance, the University of Glasgow, I am a staff of this university and many others. We come from different cultures, different traditions, and different exposure. We meet here for the collective for progress of why University was established. Coming to this University, we introduce our own belief. We also introduce our own secrets and also want to do what? Do those things that will not even promote the reason why the university was not established, but also your own selfish interests. And as such, we bring fusion that we cracks what we describe as a organizational cracks. The stakeholder interactions, we are stakeholder as a start of this university. You are a stakeholder right from the gate. So if this is the one first time visitor entering this university and getting to the main page, you need man in one way or another, create a condition where the first time will complain. It believes that the entire workforce of this university are bad. I remember about 1973 when we had the commissioner called Amadi University from Yoruba. So then, the Yoruba did in my fault. That was their center. And in my fault, they didn't really have. Until one of the traditional leaders said, no, enough was enough. And the second group was fine and godless. You know when I said fine. So, after having interest, family, and claims, this is the national university. What are the rules governing us? The rules governing us are because we are here to bring human beings who will do what? Promote and grow Nigeria tomorrow. So, the message we have to bring by way of our election will also affect the development of this Nigeria. Therefore, individuals working within this university or not to introduce their personal ego, which can bring down the image of the government or going to the image, but it is important to have a good image. When God said, what people say about you, the Pharisees say something, we'll get to their friends. So, based on this, we have the Entropic and Negentropic, which is the what, why we are here. Because a lot of us look at what Entropic is and Negentropic say, what is this man talking about? But today, you will understand that Entropic as a term is derived from physical science. Physical science, especially national body lodges it to an office. Is it not? Dean? Okay. I hope I'm here. Yeah, in an organization, we have human beings who create problems. So these problems constitute as entropy, but they do not allow the organization to flow or run the way it's supposed to. So it's the degree of disorder that knowledge in the system such in an organization or institution. From social science perspective, entropy is viewed as an increase in disorder. When something is not in order, it's more disorder than great anarchy. So we have looked at other things qualifying entropy. I would say yes. Misconduct is an entropy. Corruption is everywhere. Everywhere. Lawlessness is just some official not obeying traffic rules. Or an official, because I'm an official, and I can do whatever thing I like. Vice versa, you remember that sometimes 2 weeks ago, in Vasco de la Tara, they are taken in Jerusalem. In Jerusalem, who was not admitted officially and sent to the National Youth Service. So it was only God that made the decision to realize and recognize the fact that they have committed entropy.
That will make us go home.
happen if we are paid salary. Yes, we use the salary to do what? To develop our family. But if you want to make money more than what you're supposed to be, then you are creating entropy. Therefore, to avoid that, we are recommending for the entropy. The Bible is the amount of creation described the earth in Genesis 1, verse 2. As formless and dissolute. This really is a consolidation of the concept of entropy. But sleeping through the miserable, you will observe that what you read every morning is ISIS, corruption, fighting, death, Okora, this and that. But even in the basic journalism tutorial, we normally say bad news is good news. That's what you want to hear. Or when dog bites you, do you consider that as news?
No. It is not news.
Because you know that dog always bites human beings. But if Richard Amadi bites dog, it becomes there. Ask question. Is it okay to bite a dog? No. Please take it to psychiatric hospital. Robots, you are there. So, one may die for us, is there hope in the world marked by entropy? That is the question, sir. Version 4, sir. There is hope. The only hope is what? Public relations. Must thrive in heaven. Law or lawyers or court will not thrive in heaven. Sickness will not thrive, but God has already made everything sickness. Don't you like the picture? Well, we are here. But in heaven, God is the master. So it is only one nation that will drive God. There must be nation.
To showcase
you think for one person and will come up with recommendation that you must always dress well. If you want to be accepted, you must dress well. If a man has a national, will be either chasing or run away because it's not part of us. So your dressing can take you to heaven or your dressing can take you to hell fire. We have smaller stakeholders such as the shareholders, the customers, the sponsors, and others. So the publication officer must ensure in all situations to ensure that there is cordiality between the organization is working and those stakeholders. I will only take one definition of publication. We say that it is a deliberate plan and sustained effort by an organization to establish a good way and mutual understanding between it and their target focus. There are different deliberate. Population is not something that is recurring, it's not firefighting, it's something that is deliberate and it must be planned. Lack of planning to do what, make you to do what, and utility. So when you plan, you will achieve. But if you don't plan, you will waste both money and even other resources. And it's something that must be sustained. You cannot do it like what when we are in school they say what is a fight and run. He who fights and run away will do what? Will come back to fight. So population is something that is sustained, you must sustain it from time to time. Those of us that have you go to the police station to do what? You break it. If you don't break it, someone will pass it. You are very good with this nation. So the main goal of population is established with the local beneficiary. Based on truth. Truth. Truth is said. You must be truthful to both the customers, the consumers, the population, and every other concerned person in that population. But if you cannot describe falsehood is very, very wrong because every organization, both university and university, are in competition. But I have to thank my patron that today, university image is below, in fact, it's above first. If there is anything to say first, we are here. Why? Because he understands the population's concept. He makes use of populations using the knowledge in law. To by lot this university. So we are in a good relationship. Both his office and other offices. Their knowledge, a population of their knowledge, apart from that relation to the society, laws are made. You have ghost communities, you have policies. The population must be knowledgeable regarding what is happening in society and what full information. Once you got information, it will open your eyes and do what? Enter the world. Population as a leader. Population as a leader of the task is essential to harmony, peace, progress, and order. Therefore, have function of what population should do for us and what population should not do for us. One of the basic functions of population is research. Research is fact finding. No research, you will fall into the city. So, as an organization, you have the society as its own. Then you also have what the society talk about me. What do they say about me? Am I good or bad? When we go to the memory lane, why private universities are starting today was as a result of what? Spikes. We remember in those days when strike was the one to one here. And private university said, no, and additionally, there is no strike. Therefore, leave public institutions and go to our institutions. So today, we have stabilized, but university is top notch. So if the opinion of the people are one way or the other, their attitude, their behavior towards you must change. People will say, oh, which are the money is a limit. Once it's a limit, you run away. You know, whether male or female, a limit is there, a limit. So we have under caution and passing rule. At this juncture, I want to acknowledge that the population department of this university should be part and parcel of the management team. You know, it is for us today, it's under the office of the university. But I am praying that the structure of the university should accommodate the population of the university. Population activities have very good character. They advise you especially on how to talk to the press. Population man, my people will say, what engineer? Chief, am I right? What engineer? What no me no any? If you got me, nah. Literally, that means that you must have a population. Listen, people run both here and there. You do not need a magician to tell to go away person somebody is not happy. But you must listen. That listening is what research. You must find out what are the people complaining about. And as a way, you must try as much as possible to ameliorate their problem. We have program design and population, that is why I say their position in the university must be interested or should be interested to talk about that university. Every month, every year, population officers and students design programs. And these programs must be carried out. The essence of this program is to promote the activities of the nation or bring among staff, because people want to know what is happening, how they will attack it, and what the action is. So, population plan is in the better position to do that. Let's go to the individual. Population plan is placed to other employers, to be the employers and the employees. Then, between the stakeholders, child, and students. So, it is due to the population. The office of student relations should be carried out apart from government office. Office of student relations officer. And I must say, the only one population people do most universities are just enlisted. Open door for your boss. And so that is not population. Population involves things that will honor you, will ensure that there is peace and harmony between this university and this emperor. Then we have mass media. Mass media, population man related to the mass media. And mass media is a channel through which every information gets to the target public. Whether you enjoy it, you are in the home, and you have your transistor radio, or you have the ability to buy a newspaper, to not be informed. Because if you are not informed, what are you to have informed? So in mass media, we have other channels, such as radio, such as television, internet, newspaper, and so on. Those are the means through which every information related to that organization are passed target public or to change their mind to bring them together so that they will see them as being socially responsible. If a certain population from neglected concept, before that population has been neglected, rejected, subdued as a result of a non-recognition of their role in society. People believe that population is marketing. It is not. Population is not marketing. My their job is to make sure that products get to the man that will consume the product. Then we are talking about selling forceful and sacrifice. Population is not, we don't not sell forceful. Anybody that tells that population selling forceful is a lie. It is not the Bible. It is their life to go to war every time. So nobody should talk about forceful. Population to take forceful. I have seen a lot of organizations at the end of their term, they write their handover note and say, PR is spending 100 million. What is PR? Is PR right? Or is relation right? No. Population is not PR. Population is not also magic. But when we look at the internet, we look about, diversity. And so, we are not talking about the adults here, we are also talking about what? Population. Nobody is trying to do something magic. Magic cannot be proved. It's something the more you know, the less it's. But population is open. If service, you do not do that. Population is not in service. Or employing a fine girl or woman to be in at the session. And it opens up for a large population or banks or financial institutions marketing their products and sending young, pretty ladies which shot the gun and all the rest go and get us 100 million in 1 month. It's not what we are doing is to produce that lady to work as per installed executive institution. So, population will not be that. Propaganda will not be the propaganda. Propaganda is a technique that is used to blindfold you, make you to join you so that you do what I want to do. No. Population with dynamics and techniques. Because we do not recognize the importance of populations, what is recognized with health as the only profession. In Nigeria, the criticism of Nigerian contains the Nigerian history of population traditional debate. Now cited as Cap 114, Laws of the Federal Republic of Nigeria. By this law, population is recognized as a profession. We may not, because people misuse the work of the population, but we cannot shy away or compete with legal professionals or other professionals. But population is a profession recognized in Peru and also recognized in Nigeria. And recognize liberty because there are chapters by law number 1 of 1992 that the organization code of professional ethics. For an organization to be recognized as a professional, there must be code of ethics, which is here. They also have by law number 1 of 1992, relation and administration of NIBR chapters. We have NIBR chapter in university and every other state in Nigeria. Then, a lot of consultancy offices have been created. Perhaps people, when my brother was giving his citation, he talked about Richard Amadi consulted for University Government and Federal Foundation. Yes, we are happy that sometimes some administration recognize the importance of population as a valuable organization to do what? Help them to fashion part, change that with good. Then public. This is I want to take you to two models as brought by Buddhists, that two ways as Africa and two ways in Africa. They are related. This is like the tool of persuasion, just like the radio station, leaving the news and they are somewhere there to hear. That is persuasion. But we are recommending semantic, which is it encourages two people to sit and dialogue. If you don't do that, there will be crisis. Managing questions, sir. Question. One of the studies carried out by me was rejecting the individual membership impression in case of operation, principles, and the legal activity. This study investigated. The reason why he was a member of PDP in 2014 massively defected to other parties. And we were that there was no internal democracy. And what led to that was that there is what? Authority. So even the politicians from the what they said or that said, to tell the truth was a problem, to tell the lie was a problem. So there was a communication problem. Another problem of tackling is tackling the incident of the bus in Nigeria through the application of formation. Today, even young guests, many today, in the less than 1 month, 2 months, we hear the bus this, and I decided to buy a to do final. Why the bus? The photograph shows an Entropic manager. Was an Entropic marriage. No peace, no love, as a result of lack of communication. In 1980 or Java, somewhere between Eleven and Ogun, there was a powerful traditional ruler in that community. The traditional ruler tried to say, he wanted to practice operations and decided to marry four wives from different communities. Well, no one really knew what he had. Each of those wives decided to acquire a child. That child was prepared to do what? Influence the traditional ruler to visit to them. So they will call one and another and say, Chief, this is a totally white. The ear became saturated. And when any of them come to tell him something secret, the man will shout, what do you say? To ensure that others hear what they are saying, instead of taking it in a secret. So it's very, very bad. Human beings are wicked. So we develop, based on that, I develop what we call the marriage quadrant. This marriage quadrant believes in communication, believes in empathy, aesthetics, and decorum. Woman want to hear you better. Husband want to hear the wife better. So there must be that switch. And in most marriages, the man believes that I am the head of family, anything I say is must happen. He does not have that way. There must be relationship. There must be order. And there must be time. Otherwise, that marriage will affect children, children, children. So we are saying that men, the message from this perspective, men also should live a sight. Women also live a sight voice. And also in their marriage. That will bring order, that will bring development, that will bring love. In respect of kidnapping. Kidnapping was a problem, in fact, it's still a problem in Nigeria. Some, in fact, a lot of us have decided to kidnap themselves. But we decided to investigate why there was kidnapping in 2017. We found out that those in authority refused to do those things that they are meant to do. Therefore, the story found out and recommended that locking is one of the strategies that every individual organization should use to lock in and come to those authorities to come up with policies, ideas that will trigger development in the community and in the state. Therefore, locking is very, very important. Balance of fractured relationship between Nigeria and the community. Today, we experience Nkpachi, the people who call it Nkpachi, blocking of gates, carrying empty buses, and blocking all your company's gates. That is the problem. Because the company have not done what they have
to retire and go to the community to find out what is their problem. It is only when you find out that their problem, solve them. It is not when you come inside the office who want to say borrow to the members of the community. But you come with their problem, you have not found out it is a problem. Therefore, you must engage with the community, the host community and other members to ensure that the work you are doing in that community also saves you. There are other strategies, because if there is no synergy between the organization and members of the community, that business will not flourish. It will always be a problem, and that problem is what we call Entropic. A population plan must ensure that it is shaped communication strategy. This communication strategy is to primarily to bring in information, knowledge, development, agreement. If there is no agreement, there will be disagreement. Working with the mass media, as I explained earlier, mass media is one of the avenues through which the population plan or the opposition reaches the public. Then event sponsorship, stakeholder engagement, research, and post-call analysis. Meetings is very important, and the facility visits. Contribution to knowledge. From the perspective of this lecture, two discourses have been established on two fronts. One, theory and practice. From the dimension of practice, a synthesis of this discourse has unveiled the fact that populations provide a more robust platform for peace, rapport, and mutual understanding when we assume the bottom top post rather than top down. Then, in theory, we have seen that symmetrical model is a fashionable model because it brings in cooperation. From the following discourse, it becomes quite controversial that Entropic is a constant in the daily run of action and reaction in one system. It is not in fact that population brings the message in an entropic world. The fact being that the field of population is anchored on peace, harmony, and mutual understanding. This is basically how the forces of the Negentropic. As explained in the book of Ecclesiastes, chapter 7, verse 29, God made us plain and simple, but we have made ourselves very, very, very complicated. In very confusing terms, the good God made the work of Negentropic, but man, in his situation, has turned it into an entropic setting. One of the recommendations based on this study is to deconstruct population as an organizational parameter. Population should be seen from the group, from your house, not only organization. Two, stretching the frontiers of ethics and PRAD. This recommendation is for the practitioners. Ensure that you maintain the ethics of their profession. Three, observe PRAD practice. Well, tell me about that. Observe practice of populations. Then making the practice as a law, like extending population in line with symmetrical knowledge. Thank you, sir. A lot of questions have been uttered in my life. One of those is the present vice chancellor of the University of Basque. I propose for the establishment of a faculty of communication and media studies. The vice chancellor then, through its superintendent of research, approve it and send it to the visitor. This is not approved. But after approving the faculty, we were not functioning. But the present vice chancellor in wisdom and magnanimity in 2022 used its influence and powers and relationship with members of his community. And that's what we're going to like. Thank you, sir. It is also a little bit
academic professor. Also, to take it beyond, I was appointed the Parliamentary of Faculty of Education and Education. After the installation of the appointment of the Vice Chancellor, I contested a dean of the Faculty of Education and Education. Thank you, sir. I also found the Vice Chancellor of France, DBC, I believe, DBC Academy, Prof. Minister, Liberia. I'm a teacher. The chairman of the Moral Committee, he taught me for 1 week. Thank you, sir. And the master of the law. Thank you, sir. And my powerful friend, Professor Jimmy Wood, have known since I arrived in 1993. I want to also thank members of the Latinx Vice Chancellorship that I was employed as an assistant lecturer. Thank you, sir. If that employment did not take place, maybe I would have ended up becoming a teacher or becoming a classroom teacher. But thank you, sir, that Yakubo has championed and produce beautiful and ordinary fruits. Thank you. I want to thank especially members of the planning committee that planned this body. Professor, former Vice Chancellor, Professor Bibi Fakari, and Leslie Chimizu Bibi. Professor Fakari, the first time we met was at the University of Nigeria. Then I was a student. He was a staff. And we always go to him for advice. Prof, you may have forgotten. This is the gentleman. I always call him. Prof. Fakai was the faculty of this university. There was a problem. On that note, when we even created serious anarchy that affected the university and Nkpolu-Oroworukwo community. And I was the chairman of the community. Pressure here and there. I said, no, university is the land of the Nkpolu-Oroworukwo community. Therefore, we cannot fight in our property. Thank you, sir. People in the government after that time. And there is one thing. Whenever you come along the road, Professor Fakai, which is we stop at the opposite and in fact, and she is also selling rags here. That was not victim of the government dialogue. Thank you for what you have done. I want to thank my uncle, Palestine Eda Azuna Bani, Chief Honorable Premier. There are many members of the local community who have the community chairman here. We have a UDC, which represents the CDC for Kakos. My friend and brother, Sarah Potter, thank you for attending. You are a big man. And to try to give my house, it's a goal. It's very, very not easy. Then I have my friend, Justice King. Thank you, sir. Then we have former presidents here. My fellow kids, you are all wonderful. Prof. Sorry, even if I say profession do not like the academia. Professor Wani Adele, you can recall when I was in Nigeria, you were in your contact. Even as a better brother, I was Christian as a journalist. Thank you, sir. That today you have become part of what I am accomplishing. The wonderful lady in our office, her majesty, make that work. That is the wife of the Honorable Lord. I'm very much happy. union blessed with us. My classmate at secondary school, Kanabu is two. You are all welcome. Thank you. Chairman, classmate, chapter of my name, no, journalist. Thank you very much. Then I have chairman and members of the Nigerian Minister of Communications, who have one of our most elders. Sir, if I'm not going to say, don't worry, I'm this year in our midst. This summer of our business of mining, I'm a president of NIPR. We have the president chairman of NIPR, Reverend Lester. Please, let's do that. Vice Chancellor, if I go home, I can have to be maybe seven months. So, my royal house, I'm a girl. Please carry my message to the Majesty. Thank you very much for presenting me. Thank you for the amount of time. I want to really recognize Pastor C.J. Bellis.
Always, you know, teachers always have I think that's what I'm going to do. And it is not for us to, as some people sometimes claim, it is not easy for young ladies in banks to scan for funds or keeping them in front offices. Apparently, that is not possible. It says that PR is regulated by law with specific codes of conduct. And of course, in fact, the infection of PD members in 2014 as an instance of lack of proper communication. Lack of communication also results to group members. And then we develop the married quadrants with the following core elements. We talked about interpersonal communication among spouses. That is key. And then talk about the need for demonstration of empathy. And then also we talked about development. You see that loving is key in relationships. Locking the gates of companies, as we usually see, is an indication that some companies are not communicating very well with their host communities. The PR officer must have a communication strategy ahead, and then he suggests this is a better model of communication. And then, management will follow the key recommendations that empathy should be made with life. Stretching the frontiers of ethics in public relations. We talk about deconstructing public relations as an institutional knowledge.
Prof. Bidi Maka, former vice president. Please appreciate former vice president. Let me also acknowledge the presence of the Honorable Commissioner for the Special Project, Dr. Roland Pellegrini. Welcome, sir. Vice Chancellor, sir. Let me now invite the Chairman of the Senate Electoral Committee, Dr. Olson Kwame, for the vote of the day. Good evening, Mr. Speaker.
That was another competition.
I believe the Vice Chancellor of the Women's Group of Banks.
Thank you. About today is a public relation, how to bring harmony in a dislocated world, a world that is full of rancor and acrimony. And then he said something that has to do with the husband and the wife, that the men always want to be the head and have the final say, and that in a situation like that, we cannot have a peaceful home. So he advised men to always give peace a chance and sometimes listen to their wife. That communication is the key.
Thank you very much.
Thank you.
My name is Ibim Sofimiare.
Okay, so did the lecture meet your expectation?
Yes, it did.
So what key and takeaway will you bring from this lecture?
What did you want? Well, that, I came to realize that public relations is the only cause that will be there in heaven. And then, as I can see now, every little thing now will be using the word entropy in the public relations perspective. So what we have here already is an entropy.
So how would you rate the overall effectiveness of monogram?
I think I give it a 10 out of 10.
So is there any other thing you would like to share about your experience?
Unbelievably, I met one of my former classmates after 42 years. So such occasion, without this, maybe I wouldn't have met him. So I'm really, really delighted and happy. I think I give kudos to the lecturer.
Speak of my
start. Did the lecturer meet your expectations?
Very well. We were so impressed. And he delivered on the topic. And you can see everybody giving me applause. So it's a great job they have done. It has made my class proud. Today we are very happy. You can see our group represent. We are around, happily appreciating our one of us. And if you listen, we put up a notice.
Somebody did
that. We appreciate it. And invited people to come in, and you can see the crowd. Maybe it's as a result of our announcement that the crowd is. You know, the crowd cannot collect the crowd. So we are so proud.
Awesome, sir. So what was the most insightful or thoughtful provoking points that you made during the election?
You know, when he said that only PR people will go to heaven.
Go to hell.
I'm a lawyer. I'm a lawyer, and we know that whether you like it or not, if you go to heaven, there will be judgment, isn't it? So who are the people to condemn the judgment? Lawyers. It's established.
So, is there any other thing you would like to share about your experience?
About my experience? Really, as is stated, it's a norm. It's something that in every sector of society, PR is required. Even in the family, as is stated, you and your wife, you have to PR to have a harmonious relationship. Even in the church, you know, people say they want to go to heaven, but there has to be some harmony before here, before you talk about heaven. So these are areas I'm really impressed about.
Thank you very much.
What's the relationship?
The inaugural lecturer is my lecturer, Professor Amadi, and he has made us so proud today. He has established so many facts concerning the faculty. He has made it the world know that the faculty is one that is also existing in heaven. Right from creation, there is communication, and communication is the main thing. If you go to heaven, there must be, even if you go to hell, you still communicate in hell, because crying in hell is also communication. No, the point is, in every group, association, organization, even if the family, public relations is key, it's important. Because without communication, definitely the family won't stay at peace. So many families broke up today because there's no communication. Some organizations don't function well because there's lack of communication. So he has established that fact. Professorally, he has made us proud today. The thing I want to share today is to congratulate Professor Richard Amadi. Congratulations, sir. You are worthy of a lecturer, a teacher, a mentor, and a man to be reckoned with. Congrats.
I am Dr. Paulinus W. Ihua, the acting dean, Faculty of Environmental Science, and the chairman of the Inaugural Lecture Planning Committee.
Okay, so how do you feel about the inaugural lecture?
Oh, wonderful, happy, joyful.
Did it meet your expectations?
Exceedingly above the expectation.
So what did you take home from this inaugural lecture?
There are several adages or proverbs said there. One, love does not exist without communication. Everything we do is communication. And that communication is the interaction. And without that, no children, nothing will work. Marriage will not work. Everything will work. Organizational whatever will not work. So it's important that we communicate and relate. And that will measure. And that's one major thing I take away. Communication is vital in everything.
Thank you very much.
Thank you.
My name is Dr. Jokpo Christopher Justice. I'm a lecturer in the Department of Public Relations and Advertising, Faculty of Communication and Media Studies.
Okay, so how would you rate the inaugural lecture by Professor?
Wow, that was a very good one, a very wonderful one. There was so much insight into the society we live today. And you can see that everybody has a different dimension of what life ought to be in an ideal situation.
What did you take home from this lecture?
Well, my take home from this lecture today is that God, in His infinite mercies, in His planning, has made the society for us as humans to be a very good one. But as humans, we have created divide, a very sharp divide. But with this insight today from the lecture, it is very obvious that we need to go back to the old order from the beginning, when God created Adam and Eve.
Okay, thank you very much.
You're welcome.
My name is Prince Chukmela, and I'm a student, Faculty of Communication and Media Studies.
What do you have to say about the inaugural lecture?
Okay, this inaugural lecture, I would say, the man who delivered the lecture is a top-notch in the field of public relations. He delivered it to the layman level, that even a child could understand what public education is. And I will tell you that the school has taken cognizance of the idea for public relation. The school has also taken cognizance of the need to ensure that we increase the level of public relation strategy in River State University. And I'm certain that at the end of this inaugural lecture, as it ended today, that people are going home with the mindset that public relation is not just a myth, but it's an understanding of how life is on earth and how life will be in heaven. The dean of faculty is a man known for exemplifying whatever he's doing. Even from class study, he will teach you as if he's teaching a 2-year school. So that when you understand it, even in your dream, you will see what he's teaching you. So I am certain that this met and over my expectation. It moved beyond my expectation. I didn't see it like this. I was expecting something ambiguous, but he tried to demystify the study, enabling us to understand what should be when it comes to public relation and advertising. My take home is that public relation is an essential for the advancement of every society, every community, every institution in our country and in our world today.
MSc students of Faculty of Communication and Media Studies, we are very proud and we are very happy that we were part of this great occasion. It was very inspiring, like being in the room with academicians, people that are well read. It's inspiring for us because we are upcoming and we hope to be like that in the future.
Believe that population can do wonders for the many of us in the family. So population is an important element in society and decision in every setup. Neglecting population means that we are neglecting development in the school.